Welcome back. For many years, this Entrepreneur of the Week owned the airwaves at one of the top radio stations in the country. Since then, she's gone to new heights by focusing on a new type of ownership. Correspondent Patricia Cesare has more.
In the pursuit of success, there are certain pieces of professional advice that are heard by all but ignored by many. And then there are those who know a good thing when they hear it.
Okay, where do I start?
For former radio personality turned businesswoman Egypt Sherrod, the career advice she received many years ago has made all the difference in her life.
I had a mentor very early on in my career. She set me up and said, okay, if you want to last, you want your career to have longevity across the board, these are the things you should do, these are the things you shouldn't do. Part of that was having a plan A and a plan B, working and massaging that plan B, which for me was real estate. I grew up knowing that real estate is the foundation of wealth, and I got bit by that bug much like I got bit by the radio bug early on.
It was only a matter of time before Egypt's plan B would become the master plan.
I think when we put energy out into the universe, it gives us the same back. And for me, I decided that I wanted people to know I wasn't just a voice that you heard on the radio or some cute little face that you saw on TV. I had a brain, and I had a bigger plan, and I had a purpose. My purpose, which I decided, you know, was something that I wanted to be embedded in the very fabric of what people thought about me at an early age, is to teach people about financial empowerment. So I would talk about it on my radio show. I would talk about the importance of saving, about 401ks, about real estate and owning your own. Oh yeah, and I'm talking about the latest entertainment news over here as well. But see how you're getting it all in one place. A casting director called me on the radio and, you know, started talking to me, hey, do you really do real estate, and where's your office? And I realized where he was going. I said, can you hold on for a minute? And finished my show. At that time, they were looking for someone new to host Property Virgins on HGTV, and he thought, based upon listening to me, that I was the perfect candidate.
But the question is, just how much are they willing to sacrifice to have all of this in their backyard?
Who knew? I could have never predicted anything like that would happen. I used to watch the show all the time myself, but it was the perfect marriage now to peel back the layers and let my listeners and viewers get to see this is who I am, not one-dimensional. But yes, I'm all about real estate as well. That's my passion.
There are times when you don't compromise.
Egypt has always been driven by her desire to see more people from our communities taking initiatives in ownership.
When you sit dormant and just collect a paycheck, you know, in your comfort zone, you're letting someone else be the master of your destiny. The information is out there. Pick up a Black Enterprise magazine and read about the things you should be doing. Wealth preservation is super important. Yes, you can make $200,000 a year, but do you know what to do with it? Do you know how to make that money work for you and make compounded interest so that you can retire?
Egypt also has her own foundation, and she makes it a point to stay grounded.
If ever you see me and my head just seems like it's too big, you know, which should never happen, because working with my foundation, it gives me a greater sense of purpose as to why God has afforded me the opportunity to talk to millions of people or be on television in front of millions of people to empower them.
Up next, what it takes to get consumers to change how they view your brand. It isn't easy. We'll tell you why when we return.